thank you so much for to all of you who are joining us online for this wonderful culminating event of our French-focused Song Lab semester. We're joined today by Julia Bullock, who will lead a session devoted to the Louise de Villemorhaz settings of Francis Poulenc. Julia is a trailblazing artist of the 21st century who appears regularly on the great concert stages of the world, in opera, in song, in concert works, in film, did you know that? Also, of course, in her own brilliantly curated programs. Her career is a testament to the power and influence that a single artist can have in our time. We are so thrilled and honored to hear her intelligence at artistry for the next 2 hours. Please welcome Julia Bullock.
Well, thank you all so much. This is my honor to be with you. Please let me know immediately if there's any hesitation or lag in what I'm saying, because my internet, unfortunately, here in London seems to be a little unstable. But for sessions like this, this is the first one that I've done quite like this with everyone live in the room and me here in an apartment. I really view these opportunities as intensive work sessions, and they are chances for us to share tools with each other, ask as many questions as you want, and honestly, for every artist who is making a musical offering today, this is your time to utilize as you choose. But I do hope I have I can share with you as we go along. So shall we just get going? Hello. Fantastic, both of you. Thank you so much. All right. First off, I know this is in these kind of situations, also the first time singing for me, but I just wanted to ask, how did that feel for you? Just how did it go? Sorry.
Wow, this is the world. For me personally, I thought it felt good. It was in our learning of this piece together. It's such a small piece, and like at first glance, it's like, okay, this is pretty easy enough. But then it's like, what does he mean by all of this? What does she mean by all of this? And so we were just like, we spent a lot of our coachings or our like rehearsals together just talking about it and trying to get an idea of what colors we wanted to achieve, what underlying meanings we wanted to portray and so forth. This run actually felt the best for me, which I'm
cool.
Thankful.
That's fantastic. Well then, fantastic. So I also felt you both were offering like multi-resonances with the text and the music. And I guess I would just encourage you to clarify that, or I guess it's not so that it becomes calcified in any way and becomes preset. But as you are exploring all of the options, all of it's not even double entendre that Villemorin is exploring here. It's, I mean, this text, I mean, even Andre's lady, she doesn't even have a name. She is totally, this is an anonymous woman given a lot of attention and yet is completely dismissed. And to have that also being layered into your offering, so this sort of shadows, the sweetness, the welcoming of her, and also then dismissiveness of her being as a whole, right? But only this sort of like projection. So I got a lot of that. I think especially at the beginning, that felt very clear to me. As it went on, it got a little, the gestures seemed, not even vocally, actually, I would just say physically on your part, Emma, yeah, a little external. Do you feel that? Do you feel that? Instead of just letting the patterns of your thoughts race, that actually can translate physically. Yeah. It will translate physically on your face and into your body if you allow it. It's okay. Not something you have to show.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I just want to start it again and encourage you to let all of this inner dialogue, all of these layers, rest. Let your eyes shift. let us witness you thinking. Yeah? Can we just start there again?
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Okay. How was that for you? And
for me, It definitely helped me connect more with Jamie, I would say, this time. Especially those times where I stop singing and he comes in with piano. And we had talked about this too, like how the piano can sometimes be another dialogue. Either it's someone else physically there, or it's like an inner dialogue or something. But it just let me connect more with that, which then kind of helped me process what I was going to be saying next in response to that.
Yes. What I witnessed was your the focus of attention was so, you were so alert. The text also got more clear. And your voice, particularly in the second half as well, it just settled in. It settled down. Yeah. And which is a very exciting thing when you can, when you do genuinely feel like the singing is just speaking on pitch. And with a lot of Poulenc songs, that is exactly how he paces the material. You're just kind of laying out the story with these these turns and twists that you can't quite anticipate. And that was another positive reflection I wanted to give back to you, was that I could not actually anticipate the sound you're going to make, or how you're going to end a phrase or begin a phrase. That is the ultimate delight as somebody listening, to not be able to anticipate what is coming next. So, because you were actively engaged and creating. So, to just deepen all of this even further, and it's a short song, so I'm letting you run through. And also, I mean, hey, I know like the first time through it's a little la la, the second time through it's like, we settle down, we settle down. So this third time, one thing that I am noticing, and listen, I again, your text is very, very clear, but do you mind if you could you just speak it for me as you were, as if you were just reciting this independent of the music? And because I just sort of want to hear where your voice settles, how it settles itself, because when you're speaking on the microphone, it feels very, it's very even and balanced. There's a little bit of lift that happens with the singing, and so I actually just want to connect these two things a bit more.
André ne connaît pas la dame qui prend aujourd'hui par la main. A-t-elle
Good.
encore?
Will you step back even away from the, sorry, will you step back even away from the mic? And just as you were, if you were reciting this out to the audience. Good.
Ne connaît pas la dame qui prend aujourd'hui par la main.
Can
A-t-elle encore?
I, okay, can I ask you? Excellent. Sorry, I know there's a little lag. There's even when, so when you are just speaking to me, there's a real, I hate to say flatness or kind of leveling to your tone, which I like. When you do your sing speech, you're doing this. André ne connaît pas la dame. André ne connaît pas la dame. Qu'il prend aujourd'hui par la main. Can you just be that? Tac, tac, tac. Oh no, you're paused. Did I lose her? No, you're there. Thank you. Okay. Okay. One more time. Or did you do it already and it was a great?
connaît pas la dame qui prend aujourd'hui par la main. A-t-elle encore
Yes.
un moment ou pour le soir a-t-elle une âme?
Yes. Au retour, au retour.
Au retour de
Keep
bar,
going.
son allait-elle en robe vague, cherchant dans les malls,
Robe vague, robe vague.
chercher dans le mall la bague des fiancés pour, oh my gosh, des fiancés
Du hasard, du hasard.
du hasard,
Fiançailles. Good. Yes. Keep going. I just want you to keep going.
A-t-elle
Attelle.
un
It's okay, all good. La nuit venue.
Cherche, guettait dans les ombres d'hier, dans son jardin, lorsque l'hiver entrait par la grande avenue. Il a aimé pour ça.
Yeah, entrait par la grande avenue.
Entrait par la grande avenue.
Il a. Good.
Il a aimé pour sa couleur, pour sa bonne humeur de dimanche.
Mm-hmm. Pâlira.
Oh yeah, pâlira-t-elle
au feuille blanche.
Blanche de son album de tombe.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes, very, very good. Sorry, I know that was a little bit, this is not a test. This is not a test. it is to settle. The thing that is interesting though, when you hesitate with speech, it allows you to also, that means your breath also may be hesitating because your thoughts may be hesitating. So when we're talking about fluidity, and fluency in the piece itself, this kind of recitation, it only reinforces your singing in a positive way if you're doing it consciously and intentionally. Again, this, your voice, your speaking voice started a little high, extra false space for no reason at all. And then suddenly it just became very immediate. Direct. And these are values. I mean, because some of this comes down to aesthetic, right? But these are values, I think, they're values of mine. They're values of mine. And so I'm going to share, I want to bring them home to you. And because beauty of sound is kind of irrelevant when it comes to poetry and music making for me. That is a subjective thing. Directness of delivery, transparency, consciousness of what you are wanting to communicate. That is the primary focus. If that ever gets obscured or drifts away, it translates into your voice. And also then it means we're getting more shadows of, sorry, my husband is in the shot. I'm glad I didn't call him a name. As I'm teaching this class, I'm sorry. I have no idea what I was talking about, and excuse me. But anyway, my point is that the more grounded and rooted you are in your thinking, the more fluid you are in all parts of the piece, because Poulenc got inspiration from Villemorin. Not the other way around. So if you are insisting on your reading of this poetry and then utilizing Poulenc as the tool, as one interpretive force alongside your own interpretive force, that is really powerful.
Yeah.
So will you speak again, André le connaît pas la dame, and then go directly into your singing. Maybe just the first two lines speaking and go directly into your singing. And it's the same energy. It's that same focus.
Sure. Mm?
Cool.
André ne connaît pas la dame qui prend aujourd'hui par la main. Attends-le devant et pour le soir à télévain.
Good. Now go to the top, André.
Okay.
Singing. Good. André, André, André. Yeah, say André, André, André.
André, André, André.
André, André. André, André, André.
André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André. André, André, André.
Okay, good, very good. The tall, Sonale, like it's sonale.
Yeah.
Will you just experiment with that a little bit?
Yeah.
For me?
Au retour d'un bal campagnard, son
allaitel
vague. Au retour, son allaitel en robe vague. Au retour d'un bal campagnard,
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. Sorry. I'm sorry. This is so crazy with the lag. I'm going to be patient and not excellent. So what I'm looking for, all of these, you know, the sound that we use, and sorry, I'm going to need somebody to check me on, like, and we have 5 minutes, 2 minutes. Is that possible, JJ?
Of course, yeah. You have about 5 minutes.
Okay. Perfect. So the vocalism that we use for singing, I know sometimes we talk about all these different registers in the voice, but if we're just talking, like as an ENT, it was looking at your vocal folds and how they're being utilized for your singing, it's the same as your speech. We have like whistle tone, that's a thing. There's vocal fry, that's another kind of vocalism. Or use of the vocal folds. There's one more, and I can't remember what it is. But the kind of vibration that is happening for your folds, for singing, is same with speech. And when you, if you are driving at all, any extra air through your folds, there's, and it's not happening so much. It's not diffused in you, but there's a little bit of. It's just a little, right? And it's so slight. And again, it's very pleasurable to my ear, but I wonder, is it as efficient as it needs to be? Are you drifting? Are you drifting away? So can you imagine, when you think about your air in phrases, at the beginning of every phrase and guiding it through to the end, it's not going in multiple directions. The air needs to be consistent with the and complete movement and gesture with the phrase. How nice that you can just think in one direction and do one task, and then also have that fluidity in your voice and your singing. So will you think that through? Just in the second verse, au retour. Tac 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 text 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 text. Yes! Yes! Hold on. Da 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 da. Even when the phrase is going down, it's not. Da 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 da. Yes.
Yeah.
2 minutes, okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
The last line, do the last line. Da da da. Does it up? No. Again, sorry. It sounds lovely. That is not the damn point, is it?
We have to move on, sorry.
Oh no!
Okay. Okay, can we do this one phrase?
De son abord? Okay.
Yeah. Good. Okay, okay. Cool, cool, cool. Sorry, I know we have to wrap up. So do, the thing with the hand gestures also, excellent, excellent, excellent. This is not about volume. I just want just to articulate again. This is not about volume. This is just about direction of your air and guiding it through the completely, not driving your voice in multiple paths. So with the hand gestures, hands are very powerful tools as long as they're being utilized consciously. So if Melbourne, this is actually not the direction that you were using your air initially. If you wanted to start the air and go that direction for the whole phrase, fine. But you started this way and then did this. So I just, again, just as you are, as you're organizing, all the great singing is about, I feel, is about organization. And as you're organizing your thoughts, be conscious of every single message that you are giving to yourself and also that you're putting outwards. Thank you so much. Fantastic. Ooh, JJ, you're mean.
Hello. I'm Chihiro. So here's my release. So we're gonna perform the violon by Bullock.
Okay, so I've heard the first half. How did it go? How did it go?
It was good.
Excellent. Excellent. Okay. So, will you, I just want to start right off the bat with just speaking again, because there's so much that seems to be really working well. And I just want to, yes, will you just speak again? Speak the text, yeah. Okay, you know what's great about this? It is super in your body. It is kind of internal and easy. Can you go on just for another few phrases, but then would you take this energy into this music?
Oh, you mean speaking?
Yeah.
So next phrase. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Speak the next phrase. Just speak a little more. And then, but this energy that you have while you're speaking,
yeah.
Will you allow that to translate a bit into your singing? Yeah.
Je me suis gémissement tendu sur le col du malaise, aux accords sur les cordes du pendu,
dépendu,
à l'heure où les lois se taisent. Le cœur, en forme de fraise, s'offre à l'amour comme un fruit.
Inconnu. Yeah. So this energy, take this into your singing. Say the first line, and go right into your singing. Okay, that gets stop. All good. Excellent. It gets external. It gets really kind of, which, hey, I understand. When we listen to this music, also when I listen to this music, I go like this. All I want to do is dance. And that's fine. But can you take Coupe l'amoureux aux accents méconnus, le violon, et son joueur me plaise. It's very letting the music wash over you completely. Not just, I mean, that's something that happens when we listen to music. But what's happening for this woman is it's infusing all parts of her protoplasm, this material, this violin player, the sound, and also the physicality of this player.
Yeah.
So that sensitivity, this da da da, it's that's it's deeper than malaise, which is nice, but malaise. That's uneasy. It's malaise. It's not just this. Yeah. Cause when you speak, you actually have this dimension already. And then you shy away. It seems to me when you start to sing, putting on a show, we don't need a show from you. All I want to see is you being overcome by this music. That's it. So yeah, go ahead.
From the beginning.
Coupe l'amour. Just say coupe l'amour.
Coupe l'amour.
Go right into. Good. Start at the top. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Okay, yes. Will you talk about the, excuse me. Excellent. What, Chihiro, what was the difference for you? Or was there a difference?
Oh, it's more like layered to me. Like, it's not surfaced, like just connected with my inner thoughts, I feel, a little bit more.
Yes. And I felt that too. I saw it, I felt it, I heard it. So, even further, okay. There's a part, okay. So, as you're exploring the vocalism you want to do for this, because it's very, you have a lot of options, we all do, with our instruments and how we want to utilize them. Sometimes we can pull off the voice a little bit for effect.
Yeah.
But the baseline, the fundamental of your work, at least on your own and in preparation, is again with that core sound. It doesn't mean it's tight. It doesn't mean it's the same thing. It also, it's flexible. There's movement in it. But what I would like to play, honestly, sorry, I'm just thinking, the sound of this violin on a string, on strings, and how narrow that is. Yes. So if you read the whole thing, and that, the thing that's so amazing, sorry, I didn't used to be able to, I'll just explain what I would like you to do and then what you can explore here. And if it feels comfortable, continue on. There are other vowels that you can use. There are other techniques. The V is nice because we're talking violon. But the V, the size of this V is actually the place where every single word, every consonant, every vowel can exist. It never has to grow larger than that. And that's like speech, right? When it is at its most efficient, you can roar more out. We hear a lot of that kind of singing, do we not? But That is it's an avenue through which you can follow through and grow. So I would love you to try all of this, just the first line, or if you want to do a different part of it, on a V. Easy, easy, easy. It's like liquid. It should feel delicious. If it does not feel delicious, let's pick a different tool, okay? So no clipping here, no grabbing here. And again, I'm not in the room, so it's a little hard for me to catch if it's without added tension, you need to determine that for yourself. And if it does feel that way, let's pick a different tool. Yeah, but can you try this a couple of phrases with the V? Totally leveled, every single pitch feeling the same. Sorry. Can we actually do it? Sorry, Chihiro. Can we actually do it on a V? Yes. Yes. Good. And let's do, actually, no. I thought your V was pretty good. There was one part, it fell out on because I heard this weird da-ga-ga-ga-ga-ga. So, but you sorted it out. It should just feel like this liquid nothingness, NG. Same thing. Yes. Tongue trills, also another option. Oh, that was terrible. Yes, ma'am. Yes. So there we go. So will you let this kind of energy, the consistency of that energy, now get fed into your lyrics? And where I'm super curious about it is during the le cœur en forme de fraise. Is that right? Yeah. Can we try the second verse?
What, from where?
Actually, even if you just want to try from aux accords. No. Sorry. Can we do this line? I'm sorry. I jumped around to a totally different phrase than the one you were singing, and that was not thoughtful or considerate of me. Can we do this phrase on either a V, a TZ, the tongue trill? Yeah, can we try that there? Gentle. Yes. Yes. Uh-huh. Okay, let's put this with lyrics. Okay, almost. Same, identical things. Don't not win. Yes. Okay. Sorry, what is the difference now? What is the difference there?
I didn't spread it out. I feel I almost like close my mouth. But
I've lost you. Damn. No! Oh my gosh, just fire me already. Excellent. Sorry, what? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, what was the difference for you?
So, just that I felt the difference.
Yes. Yes. So, and did how what the sensation, the feeling?
It's different. Yeah, vibration feeling is so different.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. So the with the most, it's very, you know, when you have a lot of, it's hard for all of us when we are, when we feel the music ourselves, like it psychs us up and we want to pour ourselves into it. It's hard to not want to like get a grasp on it a bit, but with the, with your singing, I would encourage you to reorganize this investment, the physical investment of with like it's just a reorientation of the energy. So you're not gripping onto the material. The emotional metabolism of the material is way faster than you can grip. And then you're going to be able to grab and control the emotion, and also the physical vibration of your vocal folds is way faster. What it needs in order to not have the sound be diffused or driven, it's way faster than you will ever be able to control. So all you have to do is think swift thoughts. And again, this orientation of your energy, not, I hate Connie. Even though that can be exciting, that is playtime. Then you can actually play. You're actually crafting the experience and the expression, not just trying to land an exciting moment. Does that ring true?
Yeah.
Okay. How much more time do we have? Yes, let's start. Okay, let's do again the second verse.
Yeah.
However, whatever cues you need to give yourself. I love that you started on, because I'm also doing this right now in rehearsal, all day. And so, however you feel you want to begin, because this is, again, this is your time as you're organizing what you want to do and how you want to do it. Choose the tool and then let that inform your words. Yes. Oh. Yes, yes. I love, okay, that's delicious. Sorry, does that feel delicious to you?
Yeah, delicious.
Okay. So, sorry. There's so much talk, you know, about, we all want to do our best by these composers and poets, but damn it, you also need to do right by yourself. And it is okay to, it's not even a question of indulgence. It's like the pleasure of making sound with real liberty and flexibility I mean, oh my gosh, that you can, that is something that will just guide you forever and can deepen forever. The rest of it, the career stuff and like who thinks you're great and who doesn't, that's all on the periphery. But the joy of releasing your sound on your terms and knowing that you're the one giving those clear directions, wow, like that's real agency. Like it excites. I wish that my teachers, especially at this phase in my learning, had continued to remind me that it's okay to enjoy the physical experience of singing. And so anyway, you know exactly what you're doing. And I feel, you guys are already on your paths, but as you're gathering tools and interacting with new people all the time, it's your chance. It's just like, what are the things that resonate with you and that you can take and try out when you're relaxed and just enjoying it? But like that, for this song, you buzzing along like this is like, I feel like that will break open any limitations you feel around any part of the song. And you actually, there's no reason to feel any limits ever. Mm-hmm. Ever. Cool.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you. Hello.
Hello.
Okay.
It's fine.
Okay. Raise it up. Raise it up.
I don't use mics. Okay, perfect. Hello, I am Josie Larson, and this is Kyung Ali, and we will be singing Dans l'herbe by Poulenc.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Beautiful. All right. How did it go for you?
There were a couple things that I do that I didn't. I wanted to put more structure on the text and more emphasis on the text because it appears as such a simple song. So I prefer to try and take the text out and really make it mean something with the simplicity of the actual notes, I guess. But other than that, I think we stuck to what we had worked on and trying to create a line, trying to never really let there be a rest, because she doesn't have a rest until the second page. I'm the only one who does, and so we want to keep that structured line.
Cool. So I really appreciate and enjoyed your performance, and I'm glad that you still though want more. So there's a distillation. We were talking about it's a simple song. I don't know if it is simple, the setting of Poulenc's. I feel it is distilled. Okay. It is desolate. And the thing, it's like this very controlled grief. So when you're talking about, when you're just saying, I'm just using your words here, of wanting to bring more for yourself into this text. Do these words resonate? These are just things that have just come to mind now as you were speaking and singing. Desolate, distilled, controlled grief. Mm-hmm. And will you just start it again? Okay, good. Excellent. So, will you take this and speak it at double time? Mm-hmm. Just an experiment. Actually, speak it and then sing it at double time. I'm curious.
She's duplicated.
She is duplicated, and her anger is full and complete. Okay. Okay. All right. So, try this again. Sorry. Double time. Double time speak, double time singing. I want to hear when you're talking about again this text. Je ne peux plus rien dire. Ne rien faire pour lui. Il est mort de sa belle. Il est mort de sa mort belle. Dehors, sous l'arbre de la loi. Je ne peux plus rien dire. ne rien faire pour lui. Baba baba gaga giga gaga gaga giga gaga gaga giga gaga gaga ya da 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 di da 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 di da 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 di da 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 da. Very flat. Hey.
Je ne peux plus rien dire ni rien faire pour lui. Il est mort de sa belle. Il est mort de sa mobile. Dehors, sur l'arbre de la loi.
Il est mort. Il est mort. Il est mort.
Il est mort.
Il est mort, il est mort, il est, yeah, il est mort. These words have to be, it's like a liquid. Okay, actually, sorry, I want to try something with you, and only because you already are doing it. I just want to reinforce what you're doing. Will you take your finger? This is a tool that has been helpful to me over the past year or so. I used to put my finger in my mouth, just the pinky short like this. But I instead, now I turn it to the side. Having this extra millimeter is helpful. I don't know, maybe in time I'll want a little more. But truthfully, il ne peut plus rien dire, ni rien faire pour lui. Will you try that? Speaking first. Don't hurt yourself. Just gentle. It's a gentle reminder. Yeah. 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 Yes. Okay. So sing with that. Sing that with this. Yes. Keep going. Okay, stop. Good. Good. Okay, excellent. So, Josie, when you're experimenting with this, do not, it's not about creating the sound right here. It's actually about maintaining, a structure in your singing, a structure while you speak and while you sing, and having those be close and the same. And it's the maintenance of the structure is not a dead thing. It's something that you have to activate and activate and reactivate. And actually, again, sorry, I don't know if this tool is helpful for you, but what it's like, particularly when you start getting towards into the later parts of the song with more emotional energy, more fuel, keeping yourself organized with just speaking this text as it starts to build this is something actually, maybe you should try this instead of me just doing it. Could you try it at this more heightened energetic spot here? Again, it's not about gathering energy. No. It's just this. Not la 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 la. Yeah? Is that different for you?
Yeah, so you still keep your top and bottom teeth on your finger the whole time, and then this whole goal is just to create the lift and space within. Okay, cool.
Yes, because the inside is flexible. It knows what to do already. You don't have to add extra lift. You don't have to add anything. It's just breath pressure. From wherever you want to begin. All good. Right down. Stop. Sorry. I feel like, yeah. Sorry. Maybe I picked the wrong. It's not wrong. I'm not sure, again, because I'm not in the room and so much was already making sense with what you were doing before. Now there's extra effort that I'm catching. And again, I know I'm just on an ear thing. So that's not always accurate. Will you try this, actually, on a... Yum, 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 yums. Mm-hmm. So I know that feels really basic, but it's the same thing, just with more activity. What's up? Are you actually doing? Sorry, I can't. I'm not sure. Are you actually doing yum 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 yum? Or are you just humming?
I was just humming. I thought that's what you wanted. Sorry.
I'm sorry. No. Sorry. I want more activity with the yum 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 yums.
Okay.
Yeah, bring that over. That's fine. Yes, even faster. Yes. 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 This is good. Laughter is good. So yes. Keep this. This is right. Sorry. This is totally right. Is this comfortable?
Not quite. Because I feel like it's just
okay.
All of the things down, and I'm not having any space because I'm bringing it so nasalized and forward, I guess. So I felt less
so nasalized and forward. Okay. Will you experiment with me? Will you just play with me a little bit?
Yeah.
As you're just. It's the same as we were doing with, again, a tongue trill, a V, a TZ, these are an NG. It's all the same. The reason why I'm doing the nyum, 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 nyums is to get this activity, because you were talking about the simplicity of the song, but wanting more activity. And it's like activating all of this energy in a way that is not, it's not just you thinking, but do you understand what, does that translate? Is that clear?
Yes. Yes. Let's try it. Do you want me to keep doing the.
Okay. That's right. Yes. Just try. Thank you. Mm-hmm. yum 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 yum. Yes, yes. Yum 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 yum. Yes. Yes. Okay, 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 okay. Good, good, good. Good. So when it got up, okay, honestly, so Josie, it was so good until you got up to the top and then you shut it all down.
Yeah.
Did you feel the difference?
Yeah, I was trying to figure out.
Okay.
If you're gonna be able
to. If you were going to say it one more time, it was a lag.
Oh, no worries. I was trying to figure out if I was going to be able to create a sound on even just an F on the nyum-nyums. Because I was worried, I guess, and I started controlling.
Yes. Well, yes, exactly, exactly. So can you do...
Okay.
Play. Sorry, I know I'm not there in the room, and it's much easier for me to make... Sorry, I would do the exact same thing if I was in the room with you. But making like playful, experimental, almost childlike sounds as you are working also on very serious music, it is helpful just to unlock. It's another option for how you can work the piece. That's it. That's it. And right now there's a little bit of a cap. Because you think there's a cap, you're convinced there's a cap at that top, at that part of your voice, if you make sound that way. And I don't know if it's true. That's all.
That's right. Prove me wrong.
Mm. Or I could be, you know? Yes, 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 yes. Okay, okay, okay. Good, good, good. So can we get in the words now? We try?
Okay, but I can sing the words.
You can. So good, good. No, excellent. Will you link yum yum feeling with the word? Will you try that actually? If you were just sort of intoning this on pitch. Instead of God, just I'm sorry. So frustrating. So will you try just intoning this at that pitch level without extra vibration and work?
Okay.
Sorry, and I know that there's probably a little extra effort you're putting in now because we were experimenting with something that you had not done at that pitch level before. You've been doing yum yum yums your whole life, but maybe not in this context. But, and so it's not about driving energy. In fact, it's just about the most efficient, very gentle, very light, very easy, and despite the intensity of the emotional material. So can I, in this time round, will you just sort of intone speaking at that pitch level though?
Okay, on the words.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. Okay, okay. Mon appello, mon appello.
Mon appello, son passage. Mon appello, mon appello. Mais comment j'étais loin de lui. Et que...
Actually, yes. 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 Okay. The text, sorry, I know this may sound like a shallower to you, but actually the text also becomes very clear. Your voice becomes very clear. Will you try it one more time? On appelle, on appelle. It really doesn't demand more energy than that from you. I don't think. Yes. Don't shut that down. Good, good, good. Okay, Josie, how did that feel?
It felt, I definitely didn't push it. My whole goal is to try and float. Yeah, I guess float, but it still wanted the ring within the float. That makes sense.
Yes, yes. Did you feel you accomplished that?
Yes, until going from the fortissimo to the piano, I always get a little stuck, and I did it until three measures later. Then I went back to my old, like, too heavy on it.
Correct, 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 correct. So it was interesting, correct. The part where I really think that it caught up with you, your old habit, is abre son don fa se. You went in fa se, fa. Again, intoning at that pitch level. So fa se. Try it.
Sous son arbre don fa se.
Yeah. Fa la 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 fa 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 fa. Sorry, it cut out on you. Oh God, JJ, I cannot work like this. Okay, sorry. Try. Good. Go on. Go on. Yes. Good. Can we try? Will you speak it down just actually at pitch level where you talk already? Sol fa so.
Sol fa so. Okay. Sol
fa so.
Don fa so.
Yes. Sir, it's flatter. Sir, yes. And if yes. Yes. How was that?
Easy.
Talk me.
It was easy because it was. I know that I speak pretty low usually and kind of just flat on my.
Yes.
But then carrying it up, I was just trying to keep the ease of speaking in my normal day life and bringing it up.
Yes, that's right. That's right. Again, if your speaking voice was all messy and messed up. If your speaking voice was unhealthy and bound, this would not necessarily be the right exercise for you. But I actually think you can. This the fact that you are grounded in your speaking. Utilize it. Play on that ease of speech that wherever, and this is for all of you in the room, wherever that ease is for you, that is the place to begin. Let that inform the vocal thing. So it's not so again, if you wanted to bring in that weirdness of hollow sound, but that's not. That hollow sound, though, even so far, that has to still be supported by emotional something. But we actually cannot get rooted in any kind of emotional truth or delivery of anything if we do not, if we're not actually engaging our bodies right. And if you don't know that the balanced place from where you begin to prepare your material, that's the launching off spot. Things can get messy and ugly and out of whack and balance from there if you want. But the root of your exploration on your own, also with your teachers, and yes, in front of audiences, actually, it's of this, that's really bare. That's really honest. That is open. Not vulnerable, that's just open. And then the channels are available to you for whatever you want to do. But the shutting down, so the thing that's interesting, Josie, again, the first time you sang this through, I thought was quite excellent. There's a couple of little hangups and you, it's like limits, again, these limits of your thinking of where you can and what you should and should not be doing at certain pitch levels. And some of it may come from a little bit of protection, and it's okay. You should be protective of your voice. But if you allow this sort of to also come into your singing, because it's in your speech already, damn. It's going to be unstoppable, unstoppable for what you will be able to offer. Yep. So take this. If I were you, and again, it's only because you're already talking about, you mentioned at the start, wanting to have this kind of more, it's like the desolation of it is actually not enough for you. So that means you need to infuse it with your being more completely. And the only way I feel to do that without overwhelming your folds, which then means you're overwhelming your mind, is through this kind of speak singing, record yourself, listen back. Does the speak singing sound like comprehensible and good? And if it does, you're on the right track. Also, if it feels awesome, if it feels easy, right track. The minute it starts getting airy or painted, Mm-mm. You know it's wrong. Or effortful. This thing. No. Always. Okay, sorry, I'm talking a ton. Maybe just because I'm tired and I keep losing you. Does this make sense? Is there any part of this that we have time to just do a little bit again? JJ, is there time? Do we have time to just a little more singing? Any part of the piece that you want to do again?
Actually, I would love to do just the last couple lines, because the last note, I want it to
Excellent.
Do the same floating up, because it's kind of haunting as an ending.
Mm-hmm.
I did it effectively on my voice.
Okay, let's find it. Let's find it. Yes. 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 Whoa, how is that in the room? Yes. Okay. Can you tell me what you were thinking as you were going through that now?
So for basically all of it until the last note, I was thinking the keep it light and keep it speaky, so that way it's not pushed. And then right on the second to last word, pur, I was just kind of imagining like a theremin or string, just that just kind of shimmers out.
Yes. Yes, lovely. So the thing that's cool, and listen, I don't talk a lot about imagery when like speaking about singing for myself. Like, sorry, that's not true. I do a lot of it on my own. But when I'm working with other people, because I don't talk a lot about imagery because it's sometimes I think it's also just really helpful to understand physically what's happening and the direction that you want to give. But you all, your imaginations are critical for singing. They are critical for life in general. Every human being has an imagination. So the more active it is, and if it actually, again, it's the same thing with like the hand gestures as a tool. It is so, I love that you were just like, yeah, and I was singing this very da 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 da. And then when I wanted to get to the moment where I was really freaking out, I needed to actually liberate my thoughts in my mind. So I started thinking of a theremin. It's like, excellent. So that's exactly right. Because it was whatever that speaky thing was that was also helping you stay focused. It wasn't going to serve you in that moment. And you knew it and you trusted your instincts on that. So I also just want to like, applaud you for that and encourage that in you forever. Okay.
You,
extraordinary. Thank you.
Henderson, and this is Michael Banworth, and we will be performing Mon cadavre est doux comme un gant by Bullock. Thank you.
wonderful. Oh my gosh, I can't believe you sat here for an hour and a half. Bless you. Bless you. Wonderful. Okay, so some reflections first from you.
I felt good for the most part. I do agree that after sitting for a little while, especially with such an intimate opening, I felt a little bit more timid
yes.
than I wanted, but I felt as the piece went on, I sunk into it more. And I also was very pleased with the focus of, I felt like the entire time I was trying to really imagine what I was saying. So I feel like overall good, but still wanted to be a little bit more in my body, a little bit more relaxed.
Yes, that's it. More in your body and more relaxed. That's it, that's all that it was. Excellent. So again, just super clear. Let's just start it again. I'll just do like little jumping jacks with you. Will you just do like two or three of them for me, for yourself?
Two or three. Can you say that one more time?
Jumping jacks.
Oh, jumping jacks.
La, 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 la. Jumping jacks.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. That's it. Good, 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 good. Good. Will you do one more other thing for me? I'm sorry. I sometimes, I'm just going to embarrass you. And I'm just trying to, I would like you just to laugh a little bit. But could you ever make sounds like monkeys or gorillas or anything like that? Just like a little, just kind of getting your energy loose and going. Yeah, 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 yeah. Good, 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 good. Excellent, excellent. Okay, start again. Okay, okay. Excellent. Excellent. So one thing that's happening again, and it's just it's a little bit of a habit. I wasn't sure if it was and again, it may just be from nerves in this weird, insane setup we have here. But I feel like it may be, I'm curious, is this habit of you doing a me prune? Is that a habit, or do you as you have done did so brilliantly in the phrase before, en garde pour glacier et mes prunelles effacées, non mes prunelles effacées? Okay. So what I would love. I think I explored this with, well, anyway, will you imagine with every new phrase again, actually, you know what, sorry, again, this is another tool that I've just been starting to use and experiment with myself, breathing through my nose. And part of it is because in rehearsals, we have to wear masks the entire day. It's insane. But buildup of CO2 is so overwhelming, and so unless I breathe through my nose, it's really, really hard to sing. I kind of want, it's not something that I have utilized that much in the past, but I'm curious with you if this breathing through your nose instead of aimer prunelle, breathing through your nose. And again, guiding that breath, like actually imagining that breath going all the way down to the end of the phrase, not which is a little bit of your habit. Yes? Will you try? From the top. The hand, even. 1 second. Even the hand wind. Your hand literally did this. I would like the opposite. Can you try? Will you speak it? Just that. That's all it is. Keep going. Correct. Keep going this way, just for a little bit. Oh, yes. 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 Cool. Okay. Okay, let's try with this, and then I want to add an additional thought afterwards, because this is good. It's just an additional thought, and I'm wondering if you will even take it further. Go ahead. We try from the top, or where from wherever. So that kind of intoning. Sorry. So you did. It's literally intoning this text at this pitch level. It's not about holding the vocal folds. In fact, sorry, I don't even need to talk about this holding because you weren't doing it before and you were intoning it. I just want to invite more in the intoning of text into your singing because it's dead on. Sorry, it's life on. It's great. Better, yes. No, sorry. You got scared. It is like, I'm sorry, it is like, I know it seems like, why in the hell would you keep this while you're singing this line? But that is literally like, if you were not thinking about how your voice was gonna sound, and it was just like somebody put on like an old ass recording of piece and was like, la, la, la. It's like you, that is all, it is not about this rise and fall of different kind of vibrations actually in this piece. It is, sorry, my cadaver is soft or sweet like a glove. Yes? So it's like you're having this out of body experience. And again, it's like this talking about these, what, and make, my erased pupils and my eyes of stone, my white eyes of stone. It is the most, it's life within this death image, but it has to be so precise. And so actually, instead of trying to think about the singing again, what I would actually like us to do together, sing the tones on the pitch, but intone it, instead of thinking about the singing of it, intone. Just as you were doing before, at any pace that feels right, don't, and let go of this thing of the singing. Mm-hmm. Let it go.
Yeah, okay.
If you can, if you dare.
On the pitches too? Mm-hmm.
Yes, on the pitches too. So go ahead. I'm back. How'd it go? Okay. So the little bit that I heard, again, you do not need to sound like a boy soprano. It's not about raising your larynx. Go ahead, you try. Oh, yes. 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 Okay, I love this. Now, while keeping in this task, I would like to add this to it. Can you pretend like you're drooling? Drooling all the way down the end of the phrase. Add this in with it. Hold on. Drooling down always. Not drooling. No. It's all drooling. Sorry. It's getting late for me. So I've lost my cookies. The thing is, with the drooling, adding in the idea and the act, not the idea, the actual act of drooling downwards with this intoning, it allows you, again, not to get this little, like a little boy soprano, but actually as a grown woman talking about, ah! It's the same thing again as following that breath all the way through to the end of the phrase and not reorganizing for a note to happen, not reorganizing for a word to sound placed and lovely. No one gives a shit how lovely this sounds. It should be the weirdest release of energy out of your body.
Okay.
Does that feel okay? Because that's also this music. That's the text. That is the text. Sorry, this is getting crazy. But I'm trying to link what the vocalism is of this piece with also then a physical action that feels legitimate and grounded. So your imagination is hooked up, your body is hooked up, you have physical tools to, and lots of modes of entry in order to keep, at the end of the day, it always gets back to the most efficient use of the voice. And so when I hear any little alteration in your vibrato, oh my God, it's still very nice. Like, I would still pay money to listen to you sing this. That is not the point. I think you can do better, and I do not think you're satisfied. That's the point. So can we try again with this, with the drooling? which is releasing energy out and down. Okay, one more time. Close your eyes. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes. So that drooling, can you actually take it? Can you imagine that that is going, it's going like, it's seeping down out of your mouth, down your chin and onto your tummy. It's like, it's seeping that low and that deep. So when, even with the exercise, it's not, it's just intention of energy. That's it, because it's, and that is intention of your air flow. That's all. One more time. It's so close. You're so close. Keep going. Don't get excited.
Yeah.
Don't get excited by your own singing. Just stick to the task. It's okay. Wow. It is so different though. Sorry. It's not so different. It just feels more complete. It's not like this trying to be, I don't know. It's not trying to sound nice anymore. It's just like, it just feels like a real release of energy from your body, which is supported in the lyric. So let's go again. So even with a phrase where there's like a lift up at the end, keep that energy releasing downward. And then also if it's a pitch where that's higher, it's still anticipated with the energy of release of drooling. Okay, go again. Enough talking. I don't know. I'm lost now. Thank you. Try it one more time and drool already. Yes, ma'am. Time, do that last phrase one more time. Drool that. Almost. Just say go. That's it. That's all it is.
Yeah.
That's, dang it. That's all it is. Yeah. Yeah. It's awesome. Oh, do it again. Okay. Yeah. Go. Good. Close. Yes, that's right. You know. The thing is with the drooling, sometimes you think like, oh no, let me make a little more sound. Yeah. No, it's a thing, it's about breath and it's a thing of resonance. It has nothing to do with volume. Come and go versus come and go. Come and go. It's like, then it's about taking it, releasing it from you. It's not something you can have a hold on. Just do this one more time and then we can stop. Just out of context. Yeah. Good. Okay. You work on this just a little bit, but it's because I think it's something, it's such a delicate thing and it's hard to, it's also, you're in a large room, so maybe what I'm asking for is not right. But I think you can go even with, do not have to worry about being heard. Yeah. It's just a release of energy and legitimate drooling. Okay. Oh, how wonderful. Wonderful.
Thank you so much for being with us and being unflappable with all of these internet problems.
You're the best. This was the best way ever we could have ended our semester. You're the best. We hope you come back again and again. Thank you so much.
You too. Thank you all. Thank you all so much. Thank you. Fantastic. All right. We didn't. JJ, we didn't set up any time for any questions or anything. Or people need to go. That's fine too. I'm also sleepy, so it's fine if we just wrap up. But
sorry, a lot of people have a class at 4, which is why.
Oh, good. Goodbye.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
All good. Bye.